Hey friends, it's Sunday School Connect, and we're going deeper in the friendship of David and Jonathan, and I'm looking for dried flowers to fill up some bases, so I'm taking you along with me. Okay, so David and Jonathan were best friends, but these two men couldn't have been any more different. David was a shepherd, and Jonathan was a warrior. David was born in a little town called Bethlehem, and Jonathan was born in a palace. David trained to tend sheep, and Jonathan was trained for war. David had a harp and a slingshot, and Jonathan had an armor. And one of the big difference they had was David was the youngest of eight brothers, yet he was the appointed one by God and the anointed one to be the next king. And Jonathan was the son of the king, son of King Saul, and he should have been next in line to be the king, yet it was David that was anointed. And so those were the big differences they had in their friendship or in their individual lives. Yet what they did have in common was both men were warriors and both men were men of faith. So David and Jonathan first met soon after David had just slain Goliath the giant, and many of you probably have known or heard that story before. And David, being the youngest of these eight brothers, no one really thought that he would be the one to defeat this giant, and yet he did with a slingshot, and he was a big deal, of course, at the time. And so Saul wanted David with him all the time, because he used to go back and forth between playing the harp for the king and going back home to tend the sheep. But Saul wanted him with him all the time. And so David and Jonathan met, and instantly the Bible said that they formed this bond, and they had this pact and this pact of friendship. And Jonathan even gave David his tunic, his robe, his sword, and one more thing, I can't remember. But you know, that's how much Jonathan loved him. He loved him as himself, the Bible said, and he basically gave him a whole armor. And so King Saul was jealous of David. He basically grew jealous of him because one day the women came out and they were singing songs, dancing, and they were singing that King Saul killed thousands of men, where David killed tens of thousands of men, you know, in battle at the time. And so King Saul grew jealous of that and had this just plan, this vendetta to go after David and kill David. And that was his mission. He wanted him killed. And so all of the details of that, of the times that Saul tried to kill David or went after David, and all the details of Jonathan trying to speak with his father about David and trying to protect David, all those details are chapters in 1 Samuel and 2 Samuel. So if you want to know more details about that, definitely check these books out in the Bible. But the other few things that happened, you know, to note, I guess, with this friendship or this time, was that David actually married Jonathan's sister. So they're also brother-in-laws. And Jonathan protected David and saved his life, like we've talked about in Sunday school in a minute. And David was chosen by God to be the one to replace Saul. And that's a huge deal, because technically that would have been Jonathan's spot. But Jonathan, whereas most friends or most people would have become jealous of David, Jonathan supported David. He was not jealous of him at all. In fact, he knew and agreed and saw what God saw in David, and supported his friend to be the next king. And in fact, on the last time that they saw each other, he even told David that he will be the next king and that Jonathan will stand second to him and be next to him. And that is such an awesome friend to have. So four things we can take away from David and Jonathan's friendship is that, one, friendship is a gift from God. And if we have a friendship that is so loyal and supportive and loving and have each other's backs, just like Jonathan and David did, then we are so blessed, and that's such a gift from God. Number two, a good friend loves you as himself or herself. And the Bible is known for that golden rule where it says, you know, love your neighbor as yourself. And in fact, this is actually the core essence of Jesus as well as our friend, or Jesus and his friendship that he offers us, that personal friendship, is that, you know, he loves us as himself. And the Bible also says, you know, that there's no greater love than this, that a man would lay down his life for his friends. And that's exactly what Jesus did. So David and Jonathan's friendship portrays the friendship that Jesus also offers us. Number three, a good friend is true through and through. That's a tongue twister, but a good friend is true through and through. Jonathan even had to, I mean, can you imagine the spot that Jonathan was in? This was his own dad, the king, that was after his best friend trying to kill him. He's tried talking to his dad about David, and one time at dinner, when he was trying to see if his dad was still trying to kill David, he even questioned his dad, why are you trying to kill him? What has he done wrong? And his dad was so angry and full of hatred towards David that he even hurled a spear at his own son, at Jonathan, and he tried to kill Jonathan. And so when Jonathan saw that fury that his dad had on David, so much that he would even have killed his own son, that he knew that David is not safe. And so he tried to protect David and warn him to flee. And so you could see that Jonathan had to endure a lot. It was not an easy friendship to have. It was a stressful friendship to have. And he was in a stressful position, but he was a true friend through and through. And later on in life as well, sadly, Jonathan dies in a battle. And so they never get to see each other again, you know, later on, of course. But David was also a good friend and a true friend through and through, that he later on looked if Jonathan still had any relatives or any family, and finds his son, who was a crippled man, and took care of him. And so that's a good friend. Even in long after Jonathan had passed, in honor of Jonathan, he took care of his son. And number four, a good friend helps you find strength and helps you have faith. And the Bible said that Jonathan, when David was in hiding, Jonathan looked for David so that he could help him find strength in God. Because can you imagine, at the time David was hiding in fear, someone was after him to kill him, a whole army could be sent, you know, to go look for him. And he was just in so much distress. And the book of Psalms actually has so many writings from David about it, you know. But Jonathan made sure to look for him, to give him a word of encouragement and to strengthen him in God. And so I hope we all learned something about their friendship, and I hope we all find or have a true friend like Jonathan, and I hope we also are a true friend to somebody else like Jonathan was. And I hope we are blessed with the friendship that David and Jonathan shared, because they were the best of friends in the Bible.